Hello and welcome to Building Context. This is a series of videos, of Tech Talk videos, where we go into the topic of APIs and API security. And my name is Chris Westfall. I head up product marketing here at Salt. And today I'm joined by Michael Ospitzky, former Gartner analyst and current technical evangelist here at Salt Security. Michael, welcome to the episode.
Hi, Chris. It's great to be here.
Awesome. We're excited to have you here. And today we're going to be talking about APIs and how APIs have really, I'll just say, broken your security stack and really broken the way that, or changed the way that we need to think about security. So I really want to pick your brain and talk a little bit about your perspective and what you've seen and where we're at. And I know in subsequent videos, we'll dig deeper into this topic as well. But let's start off by kind of framing the problem. Is it safe to say that the majority of applications today are API-based? What are you seeing?
Yeah, absolutely. Applications and infrastructure, right? We're seeing that. I'm sure we'll get into that in future discussions. But yeah, if you're doing anything like Kubernetes, you're working with APIs or cloud for that matter. So API is not new, right? If you've been in the IT space at any point in the past couple decades, you've heard of APIs. You may have been working with things like SOAP APIs or XML. These days, it's a lot more RESTful APIs or REST APIs. It's a style, not a standard, which does lead to a lot of uniqueness, which we're going to get into. But there's kind of been this explosion of REST APIs. And it's an evolution of kind of a design practice of service-oriented architecture, right? And building units of functionality that you can repurpose for different systems, different applications. We'll talk about this a bit today, how are application teams kind of putting together applications? Like, what constitutes an app? Under the hood, it's a lot of APIs. Could be tens, hundreds. And if you're talking about an entire organization, it could be thousands. Right?
Let's talk a little bit about the difference between what we're calling a traditional app and an API-based app. How are they different? How are the components different? Maybe we can talk a little bit about
I'd say when I think traditional application and kind of that mindset of a maybe more traditional security practitioner, you might think some static web pages that exist on a web server like IIS or Apache. Maybe you've built some dynamic web pages, server-side content with .NET, ASP pages or JSP. So a lot of that technology, it's still 20 years old. You still see, plenty of these cases, right? Like, a blog, it's static content. WordPress pages, static. But those things can quickly evolve, right? The more interactive you want the web application to be, you start getting into this world of, dynamic server-side pages. And as we start talking about evolution of client interfaces and how users consume web content, that's changed a lot, right? We're dealing with a lot of...
I would say like a lot of web pages today are really web apps, right? I mean, you've got, and there are a lot of mobile apps as well, which are all API driven. So like you said, there's a place for these kind of static applications that are built on more traditional infrastructure and technologies, but we're seeing more of a trend move towards these API based applications for a number of reasons. I guess that's where people kind of get hung up, between the term application and web page, but.
And it's, all of these things still have their place, right? Like, just like, we're going to talk about monoliths and microservices, monoliths still have their place. if you're putting together a blog, it's probably going to be static, maybe you allow comments on it, but it's static content. It's not going to change that much. So, though there's been evolution, those things still linger. And they're still server-side pages. I believe Equifax is still using that for some of their customer services. So you see a lot of these traditional approaches, but also the newer stuff, which coincidentally makes it very hard for application teams and IT teams and security teams to kind of wrestle with everything and maintain it, build it, maintain it, operationalize it, but then secure it, right? You're dealing with many different types of apps, right? It's not just this self-contained thing that is easily diagnosed and protected. And the web app, a modern web application is it's really broken down into units of functionality. Typically that's web APIs that would power that. And then they can be repurposed, right? So you might see a web API used in a web app or mobile app, and then it's going to be used somewhere else in some middleware or yet another web application, and pretend, depending on your use cases in the organization, maybe it's you're using something for e-commerce, but maybe there's another customer service backend for employees or users. So you might use, authentication and authorization APIs across them. So this kind of service reuse, right? That's kind of a principle of service-oriented architecture as well. But if you're going to build this, you want to build it so it can be reusable in other applications. So it's kind
I
of that
guess that's a big difference
that goal.
between traditional apps and API-based apps, right? Is that concept of reuse, right? In traditional apps, you have to rebuild it each and every time. And
I mean, development, it's, it takes time, right? You need manpower to do that. You need subject matter expertise. So if you're going to build something, you want to kind of think ahead, like, well, would there be a reason I'd want to kind of use this in another potential business case? So kind of that drives a lot of modern design and development, right? If you're going to build something, think about bigger picture. Can this be reused somewhere else? And typically web APIs are the way you would kind of structure that.
I guess, I mean, from a development standpoint, that makes a lot of sense, right? Time to market, you're pulling something off the shelf, like you were saying, I don't know, authentication, for example, or maybe there's a component of an application where you need to present a user page or something, to that end. But the challenge when it comes to security is now you're stitching together different chunks of logic developed by different teams, making different assumptions about how it's being used and how it's being secured. I mean, that presents a huge problem, right, when it comes to security. And oftentimes things kind of get forgotten or assume that they're taken care of and they're not. And that's where it gets really difficult to kind of secure things. The other thing is that APIs have been around for it seems like forever. I mean, in technology years, it's been about 20 years, which is almost forever.
It's like dinosaur.
It's like dinosaur years. So I think, a lot of people think, man, this is not new technology. The fact that we're using them more is kind of a new component, but the fact that APIs have been around forever, I think a lot of people make the assumption that security is taken care of. What are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, it's so I mean you kind of touched on some facets of it, right? It's important to think about kind of the pace of development, right? Like how quickly APIs are being built or changed, right? So you have kind of this driving force of agile methodologies and DevOps practices that allow you to develop and release much faster, right? So there's a higher rate of change, but when organizations start building APIs around their intended business logic, it creates a lot of opportunities, right? Like, well, I can now repurpose this for something else, right? It has much more than kind of that initial use case. So it's very hard to kind of think of, long term, what are all the potential impacts? Like, this actually comes back into play when you start talking about threat modeling and reviewing design plans. It's very hard to kind of anticipate, well, how's this API going to grow? How, what are the changes we're going to be making to it? How will we connect to other systems and networks with APIs and the, kind of the, I'd say the API economy, which is kind of, everybody's kind of working with APIs, building them, integrating them, acquiring them, because that is what powers applications and infrastructure. There's kind of this explosion of APIs, and you also see this in like software supply chain. We started to see some of this with very recently with recent incidents and breaches. So that interconnectedness, right? You might consume an API, but you are not the creator of it. So how do you secure that thing? Maybe you're consuming the Google Maps API. How do you know what data that's going to serve? And are you passing the right data to Google, right, over trusted network connections? So there's a lot of aspects of security that might be thought about in kind of the microcosm of like, well, this is the API I built, and maybe only looked at it day one, and now we're on day 100. So is it still secure? But now you're not looking at it end to end, like as part of the integrated application or system. Are all those API interactions secure, right? You have to look at this
You
bigger
can't look at
picture
it,
and
right? You can't look at it in isolation, right? You need to look at
and that.
the composition of these APIs and the application itself and how it works
Yeah,
together.
and it's it's very difficult to do that manually, even if you have the subject matter expertise. I mean, you could be talking days, weeks, months to try to analyze a system, ultimately, which we'll be talking about, through the series, but you have to kind of look at things in runtime, right? Because there's variance between intended design and what you think was coded, and then what is actually the running, API, but then the integrated APIs and this, kind of spider web of interconnectedness. So yeah, it's not a simple task by any measure, right? There's a lot of different aspects to, securing APIs.
Well, I think the other consideration is that, like you said, the APIs are being used more and more. They're really the building blocks for these applications. And we can make a couple of assumptions based on that statement. Number one, there's more of them. There's more of an attack surface. It's more of an attractive target for an attacker because these are the core components to, you mentioned digital transformation. These are the core components to a lot of core business applications, revenue driving applications, customer facing app, these aren't all just behind the firewall driving microservices environments. The other thing is that, you mentioned something like Google Apps, but or Google Maps, but you've got banks and healthcare and retailers and everybody is building web-based applications, mobile applications that are API powered. And there's a lot more sensitive data being sent over APIs, right? It's not just behind the scenes, machines talking to machines. That fact and the reality that APIs are, I think, a little bit more ex or a lot more exposed than a traditional application, kind of really changes the way that we need to think about security. So there's a lot of different components that really have changed
Yeah, it's a very good
security.
point, Chris, right? So it's like, yes, we are building more APIs, but oftentimes those APIs need to be exposed, right? So they're internet facing or public or open, right? Depending, what is your business case? But, maybe you have a need to expose an API that allows anonymous users. So how do you enforce authentication and authorization in those cases? You might not be able to. So those are, I'd say, the business drivers that really throw a wrench in the works of traditional security approaches. And it's absolutely true, right? Kind of the older world of APIs, they oftentimes were internal, right? Like you had middleware servicing other applications, and you might only expose some web servers or app servers in your DMZ. It's very heavily firewalled, but there is no API communication. So yes, APIs have kind of moved outside of your network perimeter, and it's kind of by design, right? You have to do that to enable business. And for most organizations, you can never say, no, we can't do this, right? Because that's the bread and butter for the business. So it's like, that horse has already left the barn. You can't fight that battle, or you might be looking for a new kind of career at that point.
Exactly.
So yeah, it's like APIs are here. You see this a lot with organizations that have kind of transformed, have become more modern businesses, but they embrace technology, and ultimately APIs are kind of front and center there, right? Because that's what's going to power your business logic and data exchange. So if you're doing business these days, you're working with APIs.
Definitely. Well, and the other thing is that you know, back to the point that APIs by nature are exposing the logic. You talked about authentication, authorization. I mean, these are all best practices. You know, we need to be doing these things. But for a public-facing application or a public-facing API, I mean, that's a really low bar for an attacker to step over, right? You think about a retailer or you know, USPS a few years ago had a vulnerability disclosure. I mean, how long does it take to set up a USPS account? Download the application, sign up for an account, and you have access to poke around and start looking at the API and look for vulnerabilities. So, I think, you know, a lot of people have a false sense of security, thinking they're doing these, you know, some of these kind of foundational best practices, but you really need to go further. And I think that's a great topic for for the next episode, is to talk about a little bit about what people are doing today. You know, where those technologies or where those tools kind of fall short, and what we need to start thinking about when it comes to actually securing APIs. So,
Yeah,
Michael, I'd
absolutely.
like to ask you back for another episode if you're available, and we can dig
Yeah,
deeper
happy to
into this
help.
topic. Awesome. Well, thanks for joining today. Thanks for your thoughts on where we are with API-based applications, and I look forward to continuing the conversation in the next episode. And we hope everyone joins us for that too. We'll see you soon.
Awesome. Thank you, Christopher.
Thank you.